Yes. So good morning to all of you. So in previous class, we discussed about capacitors when they are connected in series, what will be their equivalent capacitance? C equivalent, 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 we got. And when the capacitors are connected in series, charge on each and every capacitor should be same, Nana. They will be same. And potential and all the capacitors will be equal to sum of potential on individual capacitors. Okay, these two points you should remember. Okay, na? And 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. R C equivalent is equal to C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. These all things we have discussed. Now, let us see when the capacitors are connected in parallel, what happened? Okay, yes. Now, this is also important. Capacitors connected in parallel. Okay, yes. Again, 3 marks important derivation, Nana. Yes, series connection also 3 marks important, parallel connection also 3 marks important. Yes. So, how to connect in parallel? See, students, let us suppose it is your first capacitor C1 and it is your second capacitor C2. Now, first capacitor, first plate, second capacitor, first plate. Both you connect together. First capacitor, first, second plate, second capacitor, second plate. Both you connect together. Then it will be called as series connection. Okay? And if you connect these two capacitors across one battery of V volt, then this battery is trying to charge these two capacitors. So this type of connection we call it as parallel connection. If you want one more capacitor also you can add here. So three should be parallel. Three should be parallel means you can do like this. Third capacitor, this second capacitor, third capacitor, yes. These three should be parallel like this. So, all the capacitor, one side the plates are connected together, other side plates are connected together, then the type of connection is called as parallel connection. Okay, na? Now, let us derive C equivalent in parallel connection with the help of just two capacitors. Okay, na? Yes. Now, let us suppose this is your first capacitor C1, okay, and this is your second capacitor whose capacitance is C2, okay. Let us suppose these two are connected in parallel like this across a battery of potential difference V volts, positive plate, negative plate, okay, na? Yes. Now, since students, always you remember one point, already this point already you have studied in your 10th class, parallel connection of resistor also, that always in parallel, voltage must be same, potential difference should be same in parallel connection. So here, this battery, C2 capacitor, C1 capacitor, these three are in parallel connection, means whatever the voltage is there due to this battery, that same voltage will appear across C2, across C1 also. Okay? Yes. Now across C2, the voltage is V. Across C1, again the voltage is V. Because they are in parallel. Okay? Yes. Remember, in parallel connection, potential difference is same. Clear? Yes. And because the capacitance of each capacitor is different, then these two capacitors, they will get charged by different amounts. Since, as you know, Q is equal to CV. Do you know? Yes, you know this one. Yes. Sorry. Yes. I'll mute all. Okay, na? As we know, charge Q is equal to capacitance into potential difference. Or C is equal to Q by V, no? Then Q can be written as CV. Even though voltage is same, but capacitance is different. That means each capacitor, they will get the different amount of charge on their capacitor. Okay? Yes. Let us suppose charge on capacitor C1 is Q1, charge on capacitor C2 is Q2. Yes. What is the charge on capacitor C1 that can be written as? Yes, Q is equal to CV. That is C1 into V. V I am taking because the potential difference is same. Because they are in parallel. And charge on capacitor C2 is Q2 into V. Okay. Now this charge Q1, Q2 from where they got? They got from the battery. Clear? Means what is the total charge supplied by the battery? Yes, the total charge supplied by the battery is Q1 plus Q2. In parallel connection, total charge will become Q1 plus Q2, potential should be same. In series connection, charge should be same, but potential will become V1 plus V2. That is only the difference. If you remember the difference, you can get the derivation very easily. Okay, na? Yes. Now, students, just now I told you Q1 is equal to C1 into V plus Q2 is equal to C2 into V. Okay. Now, let us suppose these two capacitors are replaced with another capacitor whose capacitance is C equivalent. Let us suppose we have replaced these two parallel combination with another capacitor, this capacitor. And let us suppose we have connected this one to the same battery of V volts. Then this capacitor will get a charge Q, that is C equivalent into V. That's because Q is equal to CV. How much charge it is getting? C equivalent into V. Means in the place of Q, we can write C equivalent into V. Are you understanding what I'm saying? If you replace these two parallel combination of the capacitor with one more capacitor whose capacitance is C equivalent, then charge stored on that capacitor is Q is equal to C equivalent into battery voltage. Now, let us substitute this value here. Yes, you will get C equivalent into V is equal to C1 plus C2 into V. Take V common. Yes, this V cancel. You will get C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2. Yes. So, in parallel combination, capacitance of each capacitor will add up to give equivalent capacitance. Like this, if three capacitors are there, then what happened? It will become C1 plus C2 plus C3. Four capacitors. C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4, like that. Five capacitors, C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 plus C5. N capacitors, C1 plus C2 plus C3 and so on, Cn. That's it. All the capacitors, they will add up. So, this is the formula for the capacitors when they are connected in series. Clear, students? Okay. Let us suppose that there are two capacitors. One capacitor is 2 microfarad, another capacitor is 4 microfarad. Yes. What is C equivalent? C equivalent is these two adding. 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 microfarad. Yes. See, this is 6 microfarad is more than largest capacitor in this parallel combination. You remember that point. So, whenever some, let us suppose 10 capacitors are given. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, like that 10 capacitors are given. What may be their equivalent capacitance? Equivalent capacitance in parallel, it must be greater than largest capacitor in the combination. In that combination of parallel, which is having largest capacitance. More than that, C equivalent should be there. So you should search the option, you can tick directly. If you have that chance option, you can do. Just remember. Whereas in series combination, C equivalent is smaller than smallest capacitance in a series combination. You remember that points. Okay, na? Clear? Yes. And one more thing, students, here is, see, in a parallel combination, however, voltage is same. In parallel combination, charge is directly proportional to its capacitance. In parallel combination, because voltage is same, no? If you want Q1, it is depends upon C1. If you want Q2, it is depends upon C2. Now, they may ask you, yes, Then I ask you that students, let us suppose here two capacitors are there, C1 is equal to 2 microfarad, C2 is equal to 4 microfarad. Okay, let it be whatever may be the voltage that we have given to this capacitor, this parallel combination. Some charge Q1 and Q2 will store on that capacitors, no? Yes. What is the ratio of Q1 is to Q2? Can you find? It's very easy question. Q1 is to Q2. Can you find? Yes, we can find. Yes. Q1 is to Q2 is equal to, yes, Q1. C1 into V is to C2 into V. This V cancel because it is ratio, no? Yes. So, Q1 is to Q2 is nothing but C1 is to C2. That is 2 microfarad is to 4 microfarad. This will cancel. We'll get 2 is to 6. Means 1 is to 3. It is. Directly you can say. Means when the capacitors are connected in parallel, the ratio of charge on each capacitor is proportional to, or charge on capacitor is proportional to its capacitance. Like the three capacitors C1, C2, C3 are there. Then Q1 is to Q2 is to Q3 can be written as C1 is to C2 is to C3, like that. Whereas in series combination, let us see the series combination also. You see, let us suppose two capacitors are there, C1 and C2. If they are connected like this, this is C1, this is C2. Their voltage will be V1, no? Their voltage will be V2. Whereas charge on each capacitor should be same, which called as series combination. Yes. So what you can write, Nana? Because charge is same, you can write Q is equal to CV. Okay, na? Charge is same. Charge cannot be different. Now, what is the relation between C and V? Yes, they are inversely proportional. Or you can say C is equal to Q by V, because Q is same in series. In series. So capacitance or voltage, you can take voltage is inversely proportional to the capacitance. Okay? Yes. Let us take this question only. Let us take this is 2 microfarad. 2 microfarad capacitor, this is a 6 microfarad capacitor, and these two are connected in series. Then what is the ratio of the voltage across these two capacitors? Yes, what is the ratio of voltage across these two capacitors? Can you find ratio of voltage across this? Ratio of voltage across this, it can be given as 1 by C1, because inversely proportional is to 1 by C2. Yes, 1 by C1 value 2, unit will cancel already. Okay, 1 by 6. What you will get? 1, 3. Means 1 is to 1 by 3. You can write it as 3 is to 1. Yes, it is 3 is to 1. 1 is to 3 is wrong, no? Yes, good. Nishan, correct. Small CET type questions. Okay? Clear? Yes. So, when the capacitors are connected in parallel, the voltage is inversely proportional to capacitance, and however charge is same. When the capacitors are connected in parallel, charge is directly proportional to capacitance and voltage will be same. Yes. Yes. Yes, Abhay. Yes. Let me ask. Okay, no? Yes. Next. Now, see, students. Let us take one capacitor. Let us take one capacitor whose capacitance is C. Its capacitance. What is the capacitance? Capacitance is nothing but ability to store the charge. Its capacity, I said. Imagine that it is uncharged capacitor. Initial charge. Initially, charge on that is 0, let us suppose. No charge is there, but it is having some capacity. Means if we add charge to it, it can store that charge. Let us suppose like that. Now, we want to charge it. How can we charge it? Yes. Connect this capacitor to the battery. Yes. So, just you connect this capacitor to the battery like this, positive plate, negative plate, having voltage V. Then what happened? Due to the potential difference of a battery, a charge can store on this capacitor. Because it is connected to positive, this will become positive plate and this will become negative plate. Means a positive charge will store on this plate, a negative charge will become on this plate. What will be the charge? How much charge will store? That is CV. This much charge it will get. Means this battery is giving charge to this capacitor, you can say. Okay? Are you getting? Means the capacitor is getting charged. Now, whenever something charge it is getting means energy it is getting, you can say. Means this capacitor, now once it is charged, we will disconnect it from this. Now this capacitor which is having a charge Q, now we will use it for different applications. Let us suppose if you want this capacitor to be acted as a condenser. Means let us suppose this ceiling fan is not running properly, slowly it is running. Then what you will do? You will add this capacitor in parallel, in series to that ceiling fan. Then with the help of this capacitor's energy, that fan will run faster. Means whenever you give some charge to that capacitor, that is nothing but you are able to store some energy in that capacitor. Yes, how much energy is stored in the capacitor? Let us find. When a capacitor is charged with some battery, how much energy will be stored in that capacitor and what form it will store? Yes, always the energy stored in capacitor will be in the form of electric field. Remember this point. Okay, na? Yes. Now our aim is to find energy stored in capacitor. Energy stored in capacitor. Yes, students, this is very, 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 very important topic for your board exam, and formulas you will get very important for your competitive exam. JEE, NEET, and CET. Very important, Anna. Just remember the formula. In different ways, we will use that formula. Just remember the formula. It is important. And derivation, however, it is important for 3 marks. Okay? If this year they would have conducted exam, means definitely this question will be there in that question paper. Every year, 99% chances are there to ask this question. So, very important question. You must listen carefully. Yes. Let us suppose there is one capacitor whose capacitance is C. Now we need to charge it. How can we charge it? Let us connect this one in parallel to a battery. Let us suppose we are having one battery whose voltage is V. Positive plate, negative plate. Initially, let us suppose there is initial charge is zero, let us suppose, on that capacitor. Still not connected. Zero charge, uncharged capacitor. Okay? Now, what I am doing is, I am connecting this one capacitor to the battery like this. Then what happened? Charge will flow and it will reside on this first plate plus Q charge, and this charge will induce negative charge on this. So negative charge will appear on this due to induction property. Yes. Now, let us suppose initially this battery is providing charge, let us suppose. Okay. Now, slowly charge is going and it is residing on that surface. Let us suppose after a time t seconds, after a time t seconds, some charge will store on that capacitor. Yes or no? Yes. Now after some time, initially zero charge, so small amount of charge it is giving, battery is giving to the capacitor. After few seconds, let us suppose a charge Q is present on the capacitor. Now still our aim is we should supply the charge to the capacitor. Okay, na? Yes. Now after this situation, once you'll get sufficient few small amount of charge on the plates of the capacitor, whatever the charge we are going to send, this charge will be repelled by this one. Yes or no? Yes, because positive charge, they cannot move, they will get repelled. Clear? Yes. Means after some time, this battery has to spend, battery has to perform some work to send charge to the capacitor. Whatever the work that battery perform to charge this capacitor, that work will be stored in the capacitor as electrostatic potential energy or potential energy or energy, we can say. Clear? Yes, energy. So we need to find the work. If you'll get work, that work will be nothing but the energy stored in the capacitor. Yes. So I want work done. Yes, students, in this chapter only, we have discussed one important derivation, that is potential. Potential is nothing but work done per unit charge. Yes or no? Yes. Then work done can be written as voltage into charge. Potential is nothing but amount of work done in bringing a unit positive test charge from one point to another point against the electrostatic field. That is potential or potential difference. Now work done can be written as potential difference or potential into charge. Yes, this is the formula. Now, so this continuously at a time it cannot send two charge. Now what I am doing is, let us suppose it is sending a small amount of charge dq. It is sending, this battery is sending after a time 3 seconds when charge q is there on the capacitor plates. Now it is sending a small amount of charge gq to the capacitor. Then for to send this dq charge, how much work this battery has to do? Yes, that work it has to be done is dw, that is v into dq. Potential into dq. Yes, what is v? Here is the potential. V is the potential which is developed across the capacitor. Yes, across this capacitor, after a time t seconds, some potential will develop. That potential is nothing but q by c. Do you know this one? Yes, because q is equal to cv, then v is equal to q by c. So after t seconds, some potential will develop across the capacitor, that is q by c. Due to this potential, the battery has to perform some work in charge, in sending a charge dq to the capacitor. How much work it has to perform is nothing but voltage across the capacitor into dq charge. This much work it has to perform. Yes. Now we want total work done in charging the capacitor by q charge. If you want to send, if you want to charge it by q, total capital q, how much work we have to do? What do you need to do? We have to integrate it. Yes. To get total work done, we need to integrate it. Integration of VdQ. See, here we are integrating with respect to Q. dQ means initially how much charge is there on the capacitor? Zero. Finally, how much charge is there? Q charge. Finally, how much charge we required? Capital Q charge we required. Yes. So this work will be stored in the capacitor as energy. U is equal to integration of zero to capital Q. Yes, voltage. What is the voltage across the capacitor? Q by C. Yes. Q by C into dQ. Clear? Any doubt in this? Yes, I think so. No doubts. So U is equal to, see students, here C is the capacitance of a capacitor. It is fixed because it does not depend upon Q and V. It depends upon only nature of the medium between the two plates and dimensions of the capacitor. It is a fixed quantity. It is, once it is manufactured, it is a fixed quantity. We cannot increase it. If you want to increase, we want to place something dielectric material here, or we can, we have to change the dimensions of the capacitor. Or if you add in series or parallel something, some alteration will be there in capacitance. But with the help of Q and V, you cannot change the capacitance. Means it is a fixed quantity here. Yes, you can take it out of the integration. It is 1 by C into integration of Q dQ, 0 to capital Q. Yes, so U is equal to 1 by C into, yes, integration of Q dQ. See, you are having integration of X dx. Formula what, Nana? Yes, X square by 2. Correct? Yes, it is Q square by 2. So it can be written as Q square by 2C. Yes, this is the energy stored in a capacitor. Good, Abhay. Understood, no? Yes, this derivation you should write. with explanation if they are asked in board exam. And however, formula is important for your board exam, in your competitive exam also. Q square by 2C is the energy stored in capacitor. Yes, and this formula we can write in different format also. Yes, how can we write? See, students, energy stored is equal to what, na? Q square by 2C. Okay, now remember this one. Next, how can we write still this one? Yes, students, whenever we know charge and capacitance, we can write the formula of energy of capacitor as Q square by 2C. Sometimes we don't know Q, or sometimes we don't know C. Then what to do? Yes, we need to convert into other format. Means, like, see, you know Q is equal to CV. Do you know? Yes, we know. So in the place of Q, substitute this, you will get energy is equal to CV whole square divided by 2C. So U is equal to C square V square by 2C. 1C, 1C cancel, you will get half C V square. Yes. Second formula. This first formula, this is second formula. Anything you can use depending upon your given values. In your question, if C and V are given, how to find energy? Half C V square. In question, if Q and C is given, how to find? Q square by 2C. Sometimes they may not give CV or QC. They may give you something different. Means QV they may give. Then what to do? Yeah. See, one more format. Energy is equal to Q square by 2C. So Q square by 2 into what is C? C is nothing but QV. Q by V. Because as you know, Q is equal to CV, then C is equal to Q by V. Yes. Q divided by V. 1Q, 1Q cancel. You will get half Q. This will go to numerator. Yes. Any formula you can use. You must remember these two mainly. This very rarely we will use. Q square by 2C or half CV square is best formula. Half CV square is the energy stored in capacitor. When you know capacitance and voltage, half CV square. When you know charge and capacitance, Q square by 2C. When you know charge and voltage, half QV. Any doubt in this? Okay, na? Yes, yes, yes. Students, one more formula. So just now I told you that energy is stored in the capacitor in the form of electric field. How, sir? How it is in the form of electric field? How it can be stored? Yes. Students, you see, yeah. You take this one. Half CV square. Energy is equal to half C V square. Here V is what, Anna? Potential difference across the plates of the capacitor or voltage. Okay, na? Now let us suppose this is the capacitor. This is the capacitor. Now on this positive charge is there, on this negative charge is there. Now due to these charges, some electric field will be there, no, across these plates. Yes. How much electric field is there, Anna, across these two plates? The electric field present across these two plates can be written as sigma by epsilon naught. Do you know? Yes, the electric field is nothing but sigma by epsilon naught, as you know. Or you know, capacitance of the capacitor formula is epsilon naught A divided by D. Do you know? Yes, formula. If it is air filled capacitor, air is there between the two plates, then capacity formula what? Epsilon naught A by D. Clear? Yes. And what is the voltage? Voltage can be written as, see, we know E is equal to dV by dR. Okay, na? And if the electric field is uniform, yes, this is uniform electric field, then E can be written as V by D, potential difference by D. Okay, then V can be written as E into D. okay na? Yes, substitute here, that is E into D, electric field into D. Yes, what you will get is energy is equal to half C epsilon naught A divided by D into V, electric field into D whole square. Here D is the distance between these two plates, A is the area of cross section of the plates, epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. Okay, yes, so you will get U is equal to half epsilon naught A divided by D E square D square, 1D 1D cancel, will get U is equal to half epsilon naught E square A into D. Yes, A into D is what? Area into distance is nothing but volume. Can we write? Yes, we can write it as volume. So you will get energy as, you will get energy as U is equal to half epsilon naught E square into volume. Volume, let us suppose it is volume. Then energy per volume is nothing but half epsilon naught E square. Yes. This energy per volume is called as energy density. What we call, Anna? Energy density. What we call this is energy density. Yes. Mu I am calling it as. And the two, it is in capacitors. So it is in the form of electric field, that is half epsilon naught E square. You must remember this. Energy density. See, this energy is appeared in the form of electric field. So whenever a capacitor is charged, it will store some energy in it, that is half CV square or Q square by 2C or half QV, and this energy will be in the form of electric field, and energy in the form of electric field is half epsilon naught E square into volume, or energy per unit volume of the capacitor, nothing but energy density, that is half epsilon naught E square, half epsilon naught E square. Still this one, students, still this one we can write like this, half epsilon naught E. E is what? E is the electric field between the two parallel plates of the capacitor, that is can be written as sigma by epsilon naught S, yes, somewhere else. Yes, this you know, when two parallel plates are there, which is having one positive plate, another one is negative plate, then electric field in the middle region will be sigma by epsilon naught. Yes, sigma square by epsilon naught square, because E square, no? Yes, epsilon cancel, you will get sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. You can use any equation. Okay, na? Yes. Okay, students, these all you remember, these all formulas, and very soon, means within 1 day or 2 days, we will start objective problems. There we will use these all formulas. Okay, na? And this is for today's class. And in tomorrow's class, we will discuss about, yes, class is over because only 4 minutes, less than 4 minutes is there. So within that, I can't complete any topic. So one more is there, Nana, that is, yes, Van de Graaff generator. It is a deleted topic, Nana, but we will discuss that also, because it's important for competitive exam. Now we will discuss. After that, this chapter will finish. Tomorrow, WhatsApp. Tomorrow, again, this class, continuation. Okay, when two capacitors are connected in parallel, how charge will be stored, shared, and what is Van de Graaff generator? That we will discuss. And after tomorrow, means in next class, we will start objective problems. Okay, na? Yes. Bye.